Well, good morning, church. It is Tuesday, April the 7th, and it is my honor to come to you again today. I hope and pray that this little devotion this morning will encourage you and will bless you and will bring hope to your situation today, hope in your life, and that is my prayer. It is out of Joshua chapter 1, 1 through 9 again. And I got to set it up real fast again, is that Moses has just died, passed away, left Joshua in charge. Joshua is now in charge of leading the Israelites into the promised land. God has said, you go. He said, everywhere you go, I will give you that land. You just go. It is your job now, Joshua, to lead those people into the promised land. And then he says three times, he says in these verses, he says, be strong and courageous. And then he says, be strong and very courageous. And then it gets where we are right now, and it says this. It says in verse 9, it says, have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened. That's our verse. Do not be afraid. Do not be frightened. And do not be dismayed. For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. And I've really started thinking about this. And the Lord your God, according to Scripture, is with Joshua wherever he's going to go. God's going to give him the land that he just has to step on. He has to walk on. It's his land. And the reason why that is our truth for today. And is that God is omnipresent. God is everywhere at the same time. And as humans, we have a hard time understanding that. At least I do. And it's one of those things that God is telling Joshua, hey, be strong and courageous. Be strong and very courageous. Don't be afraid. Just, I will be with you. And the reason I'm going to be with you is because I am already there. I am already in the promised land. All Joshua has to do is take that step of faith into the promised land and into where God is already there. And so how does that relate to us, as I believe, as God in your situation, in my situation, in our situation, whatever it is, God is already there. God is already with you. He is walking with you. He is there with you. You may be at home by yourself, isolated. The last 4 weeks have maybe kind of closing in on you, making you feel a little crazy. But just know that God is with you. He is there with you. He is everywhere. You may be in the hospital room by yourself without family members right now at this time, that would break my heart. But just know that you're not alone. God is with you. And so my prayer for us today is that we can, like we talked about yesterday, fall back on God's strength because God is our strength. But today I want us to realize that maybe we are feeling lonely. Or maybe we just need the reassurance that God is with us. God is omnipresent. He is everywhere at the same time. And we can't fully grasp that. But what we can do is we can rely on it and we can lean into it. So my prayer is this, is wherever you are, maybe you're, again, feeling lonely. Or maybe you're just in a hard situation like we all are, but you're in a more heightened, elevated situation. My prayer is this, that you would lean in and rely on our Almighty God who is there with you because He is omnipresent. So what I want to do today is I want to be thankful for something that I think is kind of funny because I'm in the office that I work at First Baptist. I'm kind of known as the old school guy. I like paper and pencil. I like journals and stuff like that. I like to write down stuff. But I want to be thankful today. I'm telling you, I'm just going to be thankful for anything. I'm grateful for anything. I want to be thankful today for technology. Thankful for the camera. Thankful for the internet to be able to get it all the information out to you and all the encouragement out to you. I've never thought I would be thankful for technology, but you know what? I am. So that's what I'm going to be thankful for today. And who I'm going to pray for today is I want to pray for senior adults. I want to pray for the senior adults that are possibly at home alone that can't get out. That, and I hate to say this, but maybe somebody has forgotten about and nobody's reached out to them. I want to pray for those senior adults in general and for their health. And that during this time that they would stay healthy. So if you don't mind, join me in those prayers. Let's pray. God, I just thank you for the opportunity to come to you again. I thank you for your son, Jesus. I thank you, God, for the grace and mercy that comes through Christ. And Lord, I just want to be grateful today for technology and being able to speak into lives of so many people on the internet. And the Lord, this is amazing to me. And so I am grateful for that. Thank you for where we are in this time in our world that we can have such great technology. And God, I want to pray for our senior adults. Lord, my heart goes out to them. Father, my prayer is that you would keep them safe. God, that if they're feeling alone, Lord, right now that your presence would be thick with them. God, that they would feel your presence there, God, because you are always with us. You are always with them. And so, Lord, I'm praying for them. I'm lifting them up. Give us the wisdom and bring somebody to mind that maybe we need to call, Lord, and check in on during this time. Lord, we love you. I love you. Thank you for this opportunity. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Well, church family, I hope and pray that you're encouraged today. Remember to turn down the volume of the media, turn up the truth of God's word in your life right now during this time, and that in Christ Jesus, there is always hope. Be encouraged and God bless. See you tomorrow.